Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar. In this video, we are going to create or set up multi-stage pipeline with Azure DevOps. We are completing CI, CD on Dev, QA and production environment with approval. Let's begin. I am creating a new project for my application. I am going to use Git on Azure DevOps and I am okay with the agile process. Go ahead and create. Our first step to upload the source code on Azure repository. Currently it is empty. You can use any method to upload your source code on this repository. I am going to import my source code on this repository from my GitHub account. This is the address of my source code. Select the source type Git and provide the URL of GitHub repository. Since my repository is public, hence I don't require any authorization. Go ahead and import the source code of the application successfully. Import on the Azure. Click on Pipelines and Builds. Create a new pipeline. We are going to use a classic editor to create a pipeline. So click on Use the classic editor. Select a source. My source code is located on Azure supported Git environment and I am going to use a master to build a environment. So go ahead and continue. Since my application is .NET application, hence I am selecting a ASP.NET template and apply. These are steps for this pipeline and these are parameters of this pipeline. Give the name of your pipeline. Select a agent pool. What is agent pool? Agent pool is a collection of agent where your task or job is going to be executed. You can manage your agent pool from here. Go to agent pool under the project setting. And you can see here there are two agent pool. Use the Azure pipelines agent pool for the CI and CD of this project. Go back your build pipeline editor. Select a agent specification. Since my application is a .NET application, hence I am good with Visual Studio 27 on Windows 2016. Give the path of your solution file. Select the solution file under your source code and give the name of your artifact or package. I am okay with the default name drop. Look at all the steps of this pipeline. Use NuGet 4.4.1. By default, it is going to use a NuGet 4.4.1 version. You can select a option to download the latest update of your matching version. You can select a advanced settings. I am okay with these settings. In the second step, I am going to restore all the dependencies and assemblies from NuGet repository. I am going to use a command called restore and the restore command is going to run on my solution file. You can go with the advanced options. You can use your package to restore your project. Provide the path of the package where these are located. You can also define the advanced parameters. I am okay with all the options for the NuGet restore steps. Go for now, build solution. Provide the display name. I am okay with the default one. Solution file is going to automatically pick by the steps. Select the Visual Studio version. Since my application doesn't have any dependency on Visual Studio, so I am okay with the latest one. It is going to use a MS build internally to build our application. These are parameters or argument deploy on build true. It is going to create a package, all the required files and folders going to package in a single file, skip invalid configuration, and this is the location where your package is going to store on the agent machine. Build.artifact staging directory. For example, if your source code is located on this location, then package is going to be copied on C:\work1a staging directory. These are predefined variables. Specify the platform on which you want to build your application. This value is coming from predefined variables. It is any CPU and configuration. Specify the configuration you want to build, such as release or debug. Again, this value is coming from pipeline variables, that is release. Select the option if you want to clean your old build. You can go with the advanced options. You can select the build in parallel. I am okay with the default value. You can go with the restore and you get package. This option is outdated. MS build architecture. My application is compatible with 86. Record project details. You can go with the log files. If you want to create a log files, then select this option. Control options. It is enabled. And if you want to continue this build process on the error, you can select this option. You can define timeout or run this task. I am okay with the default value. And this is the output variables. Once you satisfied with all option in this task, then go to next task. This task is test assemblies. Give the name of test task. You can use any method to run your test, like test assemblies. If you want to run unit or functional testing like Selenium, coded UI and more, then go for test assemblies. If you have a automated test plan in your project, then go for test plan. If you want to complete a test in your project by using a test hub within the Azure DevOps, then you can go for test run. You can provide the location of the test file within your project. You can provide the folder in which Azure DevOps looks for test files. You can go all the advanced parameters within the test task. Since my project doesn't require the test plan, hence I am removing the test plan. Next one is symbol path. If you want to publish or upload the symbol path for further debugging on your application, give the name of the task. Give the source path to search symbol files, and this is symbol files pattern. You can publish or upload symbol path on symbol server or file share. Next, publish artifact. Give the name of the task. It is going to create a new directory called artifact staging directory under the source folder on the agent server. Artifact name. It is going to generate a artifact with the name drop. Artifact publish location. You can upload the artifact on Azure pipelines or TFS server or on a file share server. If you want to upload the artifact on a file server, give the location of your file share path. In this demonstration, I am going to use Azure pipelines. You can go with the advanced options. There is nothing special to be selected. Next one is variables. You can use variables instead of hard-coded value in the code. These are pipeline variables. These variables are automatically inherited from the project itself. You can create the additional variables in your pipelines by providing the key and value. You can create variables group to control and use the variables across the pipelines. There are couple of the predefined variables also. You can use them in your pipeline to control your build. Next one is triggers. You can enable or disable the CI integration trigger. If you enable this trigger on CI process, it means that it is going to trigger a build on every commits on your source code. You can define this trigger on any branch in your source code. In this demonstration, I am disabling this option. You can schedule or create a cron job for a build in your project. You can set up the cron job according your requirement. I am not using this option for this demonstration. You can set a trigger on another build completion. Large application have multiple components or dependencies. One build is dependent on another build. So you can use this option to start a build after completing a dependency build. Next one is options. In the options section, you can define the properties of the build process. Like you can change the format of build number. You can also change the behavior of the new build request. By default, it is queue and start build when the agent is available. Automatically link new work item in this build. You can also get a status badge for your source code repository like Azure pipeline never build, Azure pipeline successfully completed like this. You can define the scope of the build job for the project collection or current project. You can define the timeout value for the build job. Default value is 60 minutes. You can define your requirement that is required to be complete your build process on a agent. Like you required a Linux operating system on the agent machine. You can define like this. Click on add agent.os equal to Linux. This is the just example. You can define your requirement in demand section. I am just deleting this demand because I don't need this demand for my project. Go for the retention. You can define the retention policy on project level. Go to the project setting and define the retention policy on the project level. As you can see a warning message on retention policy. Let me explain this warning. As you know that each artifact is generating when you are running a build pipeline, and this represents a build pipeline. So what you are defining here, you want to keep build pipeline for 30 days, and similar way you want to keep artifact or attachment for 30 days. When build pipeline is going to deleted by the retention policy, the attachment also going to be deleted automatically. Hence, this value less than this value. Now see, warning message gone. Let's go back your build pipeline. Next one is history. It is going to maintain a history of this build pipeline, who made what and when. Once you complete all these steps, then go ahead and save it. We don't want to run this pipeline right away. Hence, we are going to save it for now. You can see here, it is maintaining a complete history of our build.